Hi, it's Katrina. From messing up space missions to losing millions of dollars in seconds, here are the 10 roughest miscalculations in history. Number 10, the Hubble Telescope. The Hubble Space Telescope has changed the way that we see the universe since its launch in 1990. It was one of the greatest technological achievements at the time, but things almost didn't work out so well, and all because of a tiny miscalculation. When the first images were sent back, they were pretty blurry. Scientists scrambled to understand why. They desperately searched to find what had gone wrong with the $1.5 billion telescope, because that would be one expensive mistake. To much dismay, they soon found the answer, and it was that the 94.5-inch primary mirror had been ground to the wrong shape. While it was only 2 microns too shallow, the equivalent to a fraction of the width of a human hair, this error meant that instead of bringing up to 70% of a star's light to the same focal point, Hubble was only able to get between 10 and 15%. But what could cause such a massive mistake? It turns out that it was something as small as a washer that had been inserted into a device called a null corrector that had been used to check the shape of the mirror when it was being fabricated. Luckily, scientists found that another instrument on the telescope was able to counteract this effect, and by tweaking it slightly, could restore most intended functionality to the telescope. Nonetheless, Hubble was, for a brief time, the laughingstock of the space science community, and was very nearly a complete failure. Number 9. The Havilland Comet. Why are plane windows rounded, you ask? I'll tell you. Following the Second World War, the development of aircraft went into overdrive, with companies realizing the potential that faster commercial travel would offer. During the 1950s, a number of pilots lost their lives in the development of fast jet flight, but in 1952, the world's first jet airliner was brought into service, the de Havilland Comet. But there was a problem with their design, and 3 comets broke up during flight, killing everyone on board. This was a major disaster, and the comets were grounded. The first air investigators were called in to understand what had happened. This was at the very beginning of the age of air travel, so the understanding of fuselage design and the pressures exerted in the air were nowhere near what they are today. But it was one feature of the comet's design that was deemed to be the most fatal: its square windows. The weaknesses in their corners were found to be the points from where the plane's structure had fallen apart, which is why today we now only see oval windows on modern passenger airlines. These still prove to be the weak point on planes, and recent designs for the jets of the future have omitted windows altogether. This makes them safer and more fuel efficient. Instead, companies plan on offering video screens to replicate the sensation of looking outside for their passengers. And now for number 8. But first, if you are a returning subscriber, welcome back! And if you're new here, be sure to subscribe before you leave so you don't miss out on the latest videos. Number 8. The Millennium Bridge. The year 2000 was a time when countries around the world felt like they should build something special to celebrate the occasion. But London's Millennium Bridge didn't quite live up to expectations. The idea was simple. A new pedestrian bridge would be built across the River Thames, connecting 2 important parts of the city. The 320-meter-long lateral suspension bridge was hailed as a statement of engineering ability by those who created it, and excitement was high when it finally opened in June of 2000. Someone had made a wild miscalculation, though, and as thousands of people walked across, it began to wildly sway from side to side. Despite the engineers taking into account the questions of weight and pressure being exerted from normal forces, they had failed to think about the effect of people's weight moving as they took steps across the bridge. Whoops! Hundreds of people can weigh a lot. Interesting fact, armies from around the world have always taken this into consideration, and it's standard practice for them to break step every time they reach a bridge. The Millennium Bridge was, unsurprisingly, closed very soon after its opening, and after a major redesign and at a cost of many millions of pounds, it was reopened 2 years later in 2002. Number 7. The Hindenburg. It was once thought that airships would be the best way to travel, but the infamous case of the Hindenburg kind of was a buzzkill on that idea, following a tragedy that happened due to a design error. The Hindenburg was the fastest way to cross the Atlantic back in the day, taking people between Europe and North or South America in half the time it would take by ocean liner, plus all in complete comfort. On May 6, 1937, the ship became engulfed in flames, killing 36 people. It was filled with 7 million cubic feet of hydrogen gas and caught fire. This was triggered by a basic law of physics that hadn't been taken into account during its design. There was a difference in the electrical potential between the ship and the surrounding air due to the conditions that day, something that occurred because the metal framework of the ship had been grounded by the landing line. This differential is what caused the spark, and the rest was history. If the ship had been inflated by a non-flammable gas, or if measures had been taken to prevent electrical buildup, then the skies of today would probably look a lot different. Number 6. French railway cars. France's railway network is one of the best in Europe, and it's perfect for getting around the country. That's why, in 2014, the results of a 15 billion euro investment into the regional express trains was welcome news. When the new trains began being delivered, though, it soon became clear that a major mistake had been made. The trains were too wide for the platforms of more than 1,300 of the stations. This left the rail bosses with the unenviable choice of how to fix the situation. Do you make new trains, or do you fix the stations? They decided to spend more than 50 million euros, about $60 million at the time, to shave the stations to prevent the new trains from getting stuck. There was uproar about this waste of money, with France's transport minister calling it comically tragic. The head of the train company laughed it off, though, saying that it amounted to less than 1% of the yearly cost of running the railways, and that it was merely a drop in the ocean. So there. Number 5. Big Ben. Does this look familiar? Big Ben is the bell that chimes near the Houses of Parliament in London, but it took its designers more than one attempt to get it right. The first bell cracked during testing in 1857, so it had to be melted down to be recast. The new bell was then lifted into position in 1859, but over the next 3 days, it also cracked. There were big arguments over who was to blame, and there was even a libel case. Theories of the problem ranged from the bell being cast from material that was too brittle, or that the hammer was too heavy. So basically, they were accused of not knowing what they were doing. Rather than replacing the bell again, it was instead rotated by 1/8 of a turn, and the hammer was replaced by a lighter one. Number 4. Mizuho Securities. The financial world is full of stories of those who made it big and lost it all. But one of the most costly mistakes of all time took place in 2005 when Mizuho Securities Company lost 27 billion yen, or $225 million, on one trade. The incident caused ripples through the Tokyo Stock Exchange and drew criticisms from the government. It may not be a surprise that it's possible to lose so much, but it's the way that it happened that was a cause for concern. It started when a trader at Mizuho Securities tried to sell 610,000 shares of a soon-to-be-launched job recruiting firm for 1 yen each. That's less than one penny. The problem is that the trader had intended to sell one share for 610,000 yen, the equivalent to about $5,000. He typed the numbers in backwards. Even worse was the fact that the company didn't even own that many shares, but the exchange still processed the transaction, meaning that despite trying to cancel the trade and being denied by the exchange, at the end of the day, their liability had reached the gigantic figure. Number 3. The Laufenburg Bridge. The Laufenburg Bridge was a much-hailed project to connect the towns of Laufenburg in Germany with Laufenburg in Switzerland, two twin towns on the opposing banks of the Rhine River that relied on each other. The $12 million bridge began construction in 2003, with work starting on each side and eventually meeting in the middle. The problem was that as the bridge started to extend out, it became clear that each side was a different height. It wasn't just a small difference, either. The discrepancy was measured to be 54 centimeters, or about 1.5 feet. Luckily, the German engineers were able to fix the problem before things went too far, but they were certain that the mistake had been made on the Swiss side. It actually turned out that the mistake was made by both of them. When drawing up the plans for the design, the bridge dimensions were calculated by using sea level as a guide. The problem is that sea level is calculated differently in each country, and in the case of Germany and Switzerland, there's a 27-centimeter difference. When engineers tried to factor this in, they missed a negative sign, so instead of neutralizing the difference, it was doubled instead. Pay attention to detail, people. Number 2. Mars Climate Orbiter. Since its discovery by Galileo in 1610, Mars has captivated people's imagination. I mean, some people even want to live there. We love researching Mars. It took hundreds of years to develop the technology to actually visit the red planet, but finally in 1971, Mariner 9 became the first probe to enter its orbit. Since then, a number of probes have been to Mars, but there was much excitement about the Mars Climate Orbiter because it was going to monitor the planet's weather systems and relay data from the Mars Polar Lander after it arrived in September of 1999. As you might have guessed, something went very wrong, and after a 286-day journey, the probe came within 36 miles of Mars, about 60 miles closer than intended and 15 miles lower than its functional height. Any of you guys remember this? Its propulsion system overheated and the engine failed to complete its burn, leaving it to plow through the atmosphere and beyond the planet, left to float in space forever. It's not uncommon for space missions to go awry, but this one went wrong for the most simple of reasons. NASA had for many years used metric measurements for all of their missions, but one of their contractors, Lockheed Martin, had been using imperial measurements. With 1 meter equaling 3.2 feet, it's clear to see how this error could lead to major issues in calculations. Whoops. Number 1. Ronald Wayne. Ronald Wayne was one of the three founders of Apple in 1976, alongside Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak, but you'd be forgiven for not recognizing his name. The reason for this is that he sold his 10% stake in the company just 12 days later for $800. He was 40 at the time and has said that he felt out of his depth standing in the shadow of intellectual giants who were half his age. He didn't really believe, or he really needed the money back. In the following years, while his co-founders went on to become multi-millionaires, Wayne remained on a modest income, but he has no regrets, except for one. He was responsible for writing up the original Apple contract that defined the three founders' roles. Not thinking he would need it anymore, he sold it to an autograph collector in 2000 for $500. In 2011, the contract would go on to sell for $1.6 million, something that Wayne says summed up the story of his life. Thanks for watching! Live life with no regrets and pay attention to detail. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you soon. Bye, everyone!